This program is rated universal, good for general watching.
Sportswoman is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Very good afternoon. Welcome to Sportswoman on Urban TV. This show happens once a week, every Thursday from 2:30 to 3:30 p.m. Of course, we want to congratulate the Ugandan girls under 17 for winning the COSAFA inaugural title after beating South Africa. We want to commend Juliet Nalukenge for rising the flag high. Of course, we are so appreciative, and we will be having her on the show later on. Of course, we can't forget the baby face, that is the Uganda Cranes head coach, Johnny McKinstry. He was unveiled earlier this week, and of course, his target is to take Uganda Cranes to the World Cup. Not forgetting applauding Halima Nakai.
Queen.
Yes.
The queen.
She's the queen. The queen, Halima Nakai. She's the 800 meters champion, and of course, the president sent a congratulatory message on his Twitter and said that he said that congratulations Halima Nakai ... you have made your country so proud. In the house today we also have the president herself of the Uganda Netball Federation, that is Susan Anek. She'll be highlighting us on the Africa Netball Championship. My name is Becky Cynthia Nachmara, and of course, as usual, I'm with Faith Kiai. In the blue corner, I have Sharon Adong and
Sarah.
Susan Anek.
I love
welcome
you call Adong Sarah Sharon.
Adong Sarah Shalom. Sharoni Sharon.
Shalom.
Sharon.
Manager to get a mask.
Sarah Sharon Adong. Anyway, welcome on the show.
I also beg to be called Kiai Faith Miriam.
Kiai exactly. Faith Miriam.
Oh,
okay.
My mom. What is my key name? Ongom is my key name.
Eh? Ongom. Madam Susan, Ongom, Kango, Bala.
Susan, Ongom.
Excellency, not Madam.
Excellency.
Welcome on the show. This is Sportswoman. Becky Cynthia on the wheel. Adong, you speak in your language. You know, the guys out there
thought,
watching.
I thought she was still introducing herself.
Ah, so I know, first.
No, me,
first
I'm brief, as a brief case.
Yeah.
Yes, so Jolie Kanda.
Boy.
Mani Gomobir, one sports show. Your moon Kenena team. One sports woman. So, Jati Kunuwa Hokunu Langi Dushu, Lira, Nene, Museo Depe, Babatia Nenokan, Mutkuli, Lira Kunu, one of your Nini Shokan.
Okay, fine. So give us the highlight of your week.
Of course, Ibipo, if you have any other highlights, but anyway, I think it's in the levels of highlights. I have to say Halima Nakai's, gold medal at the, you know, at the IAAF World Championships in Doha has got to be the moment of the week and weeks to come. Of course, the girls that won the COSAFA, we have to commend them. But for me, of course, Halima's medal is still, you know, I'm still reeling. I can't believe it happened.
Okay.
My highlight of the week, of course, basically would not differ so much as a woman from Queen Halima Nakai herself, in absentia of this lady of South Africa. What's her name?
Semenya.
The moment I saw Semenya Kasa not participating, I just knew something was going to happen for Uganda, given the fact that how Halima Nakai came in from the All Africa Games after the national championship up to where she went, and she went on just climbing the ladders. And of course, commending the girls for bringing us that home, being a guest team at COSAFA and then bring it home with a victory. Mm-hmm. It was quite commendable. But most but not least is Vida managing. Yes, it's my
Sharon.
Highlight, please.
Sharon, one highlight. We'll talk about Villa later on. Sharon, we will talk about Villa later on.
That is actually being hyped in the country that they can do
later on.
Thank you.
Susan, welcome to the show once again.
Oh,
do you have any highlight
you.
Of the week?
Yes, please. Whatever happened during the week that has just ended, I like that comment. When you go through tough times, tough things, you achieve and you become a hero. So when people get things easily, you don't develop. But once you go through difficulties, you become a very powerful person, the way Alima is. I'm sure she went through thick and thin, but now there she is on a landing spot.
Okay, and just to clarify this, there has been news, late news of Edgar Watson stepping down as CEO, but he has tweeted and said, dear stakeholders, I have seen incorrect information circulating on social media about my position at FUFA. I wish to state that I'm still doing my work as Chief Executive Officer of FUFA. Please disregard any information that is not from my or FUFA official forum. Thank you so much. Mm. Yeah. So let's begin. Who is Susan? Someone out
there. That's what we are so done.
Someone out there would love to know who Susan is.
Oh. Thank you, viewers outside there. Susan Anekongom is my name, President Uganda Netball Federation.
Who is she generally?
She's a teacher by profession. She's a scout at the national level. In secondary school sports, we have been administrators there. So what makes me be what I am is because of scouting. I'm the vice chairperson of Uganda Scout Council, and I'm able to do all that I'm doing because of the scouting skills that I've learned.
Okay. I see. How is Netball, the Federation, treating you? Are you hoping to join another?
Well, I'm comfortable.
How would you be comfortable?
As I said earlier, as I was talking, praising Halima, I said, when you go through tough times, you become even tougher. There's a say that when things get tough, only tough ones get going. So that's where I am.
I know.
There are many things that by the side where I am ready to follow the word.
Actually, that moment when they said you bring relatives to the team.
My sock comes over, runs on any type of the road, whether it is mud, stones, or whatever. I have that type of sock.
And you've gone through the challenges.
I've gone through the challenges, and it has made me even stronger.
Tell me about that moment when people were saying you're bringing relatives to the team. How did it feel like?
That's a normal thing in life. One thing I want you to get it clear is that when you're a performer, you give a topic for everybody. But when you do nothing, nobody will bother to talk about you. So that is it all.
But was it true?
So there's nothing like relatives. Well, if I say now Adong is here, are you going to say Adong is my daughter? Yes. On the other side, she is. She is. But to me, relatives coming to work has got nothing to do with that. If you're a performer, I bring you. If you're a non-performer, you fall out. I don't work with you. So one thing, you know, netball is the people there, they all volunteer. Personally, I want to ask you, is there any doctor in Uganda that you can bring and he sacrifices, or you pay him 300,000 for a man? With the current special, a qualified doctor. She's the heart that one has and the performance that makes you do. And by the way, as we went out, that performance, when you are going at international level, there are things we follow. You apply first, like even any of you, the media, you apply so that they accept. So if you have the qualification that they need, they take you. If you don't have, and the qualification that they need one, and you can have a PhD and what, but what they need is the first degree in medicine. And in medicine, I mean, in that international level, in Uganda, before they looked at only two universities, Makerere and Mbarara. But now they have added Gulu. So you apply, are you registered as a doctor here in your own home? Then you apply there. Then the medical team there accredit you. Then they allow you to work. If they find you are not, so that is it all.
I would like to know, initially, let's say your son, if even he is your son, because you have
he's
to clarify
son,
that.
My son, everybody is my son, my daughter's.
So what I'd like to know is, initially when he became the national team doctor, was he a volunteer? He just volunteered?
Volunteering.
Right?
That was still volunteering.
No one had issues with it?
No.
Until
the
team
World
became...
The first World Cup, we went to, he was the one that won the team, 2015.
And no one would give cared about that whole situation. So now that the she cranes have relatively have become very relatively popular. Successful, popular.
The issue is because now she crane netball team is somewhere going. So everybody, because there are people who volunteered, worked, and pushed it where it is. Now they want them out. The others who I don't want to say it. We now want to come in and do what they can. But what I said earlier, if you don't qualify, you don't go. Okay. You write. I don't do it myself. You apply yourself, the person. To that, I give you the line. You apply.
So the girls have never complained about his
not
work?
Not at all.
They appreciate his work?
Not at all. Because they come and tell me they want to be with that doctor every time. I ask them why. Why? The way he handles them. The other second part of what, I don't want to talk about it, that weaknesses of a human being, a man with a lady's which is normal, it's not with him. By the way, that doctor is saved. Totally same. Not the sameness so that we talk of. He's saved.
You mean
he
when he's saved, he doesn't.
He's saved.
It stops him from saying a word, throwing a word to Sharon
children.
Or something.
And what makes him do what he does? He's a scout, just like the man.
Anyway,
so how did, first of all, Becky, before you go to the phone lines, how did the doctor come to get in touch with She Cranes right from 2015 up to right now? Maybe that is where people want to know at the nitty gritty.
I requested him. There was a need for someone. There were two people I requested. The other one said, no money, I don't come. But he said, I will help since I'm a scout. He came, did the work. When the time came, he applied and he was taken and went to Sydney. Yeah. Because the whole thing is about application up there.
Okay.
Just like you even.
And the viewers who want to be a part of this show, you can call us in on 0414-337-872. Susan, there has always been an allegation that the girls are not treated well, especially in terms of food and stuff like that. They get food from Luzira in Bovera, things like that. How true is that?
That's technical aspect. Even right now that the girls are in camp, there's somebody responsible for. They keep changing because I keep asking, where are you getting food from today? They're from here, Logogo. Another day they're from there. They have somebody who is concerned. There's one member of the executive who is concerned with the team. I just come to see them and say hi. If there's any problem.
So that means you don't dig down to find out how these
guys
are.
That's why I've asked. Just yesterday, I had lunch. The day before yesterday, I had lunch with them in Lugogo.
I actually remember calling you and you saying you're having lunch with the girls.
And you also don't have issues with that food.
Well, it depends on how one is. For me, that's a normal food. Because
like which food?
For me, I would ask for posho and beans. But I see the girls on chicken, on meat.
So that means the girls
you
eat
mean
chicken.
Even the food they got from Luzira before you went there was coming. There was beef and chicken on it.
Oh yes.
No.
You see, let me tell you one thing. We at CV4 here, you give your choice. What do you want to eat? What do you want to eat? What do you want to eat? Then they take the order. That's what they bring to them.
Why did you carry food to along your way when you were going to London? To London. Probably people need to know why. Because one, people perceived that in a negative perception. But would want you to tell people, is it technical? Is it because of the food the other side? Why did you have to?
Vias outside there. We took advantage to go to Liverpool November before. For a friendly. So when we went there, we looked at the kind of things they eat there. You eat, after 3-5 minutes, the stomach is empty.
Who was complaining most among the players?
I don't want to mention their name. We have the youngest player, maybe the tallest, I don't know. That the players need food. Real food. Not cabaret, papa. Yeah.
Not food of that side.
They don't want your vegetables.
The food,
okay, vegetables once in a while you bring in because it's good health-wise.
Yes.
But the food there is not a food for a player to go on court.
African players, because those European players.
Yeah, African players, I would say. Because for them, they eat after every 10 minutes. For us, we eat once and you stay for 2 hours or 3 hours. For them, they are used to eating every second.
They
now their food.
They snack a lot, like a carrot here and there, and in an hour you can eat
the reason
else.
Why I decided to take some food with us.
Which kind of food was that?
I took beans. Our beans is the real beans.
And who was cooking?
Not the beans there. I took moya. Translate to them, what is moya?
Shea butter. Uh-huh. Shea butter.
La Pena, the one which is...
Yes, the peas. Peas from Northern Uganda.
Were you packing for yourself?
Moya.
No. But Susan, come on. So, is that one of the reasons as to why you refused, the Federation refused the girls to talk to media? Were they worried about...
Just to stop you, I didn't stop any player to talk to, to talk to Federation. Why?
To the media.
Parent. Listen, you are a parent. When you are in the house, your child wants to get out. Wouldn't you want to know where the child is going and what the child is
but
going
before
to
it wasn't like that. Why
the on
sudden
court,
worry?
Feel free when they in, go and talk to them when they're on court. Now they have come back home. Tell me, what are you going to discuss with? Let the player come and tell me. I'm invited here. This is what I'm going to do. Now, why I stop them? The people, I call them the parents outside there because I'm another parent for them. If anything happens in between the line, I am number one.
Do you think
you're number one, but you're speaking? No, this
was it because that's the loopholes coming in, because it is true, as someone who is into communications of sports, somehow defend you. But again, the other side, I would say there are loopholes, because how would the journalists just bump into players? Do you think there's something that you need to do along that line?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, a lot. I know. I have a PRO. Mm-hmm. Okay, a PRO. That's enough. I stop there. I need someone who can do the work.
It's okay. So she's here. She's here. Now that is sorted. Anyway, now that exactly it's done. Done and dusted.
No
on national TV. Period. Okay, fine. Now, does that justify why you people dropped senior players like Meme and Nanyonga because of the interviews they gave on a particular TV?
No. Mm. There are many things people consider in a game.
Mm. And what are those?
One, discipline is part of the game. Another one, you have never been the same the way you are now. People grow up and you reach some level where you are not able to do something again. Then you leave. You make the room for others. So that is it.
So that means they were non-disciplined.
Was it
that
they
is
go?
That,
listen,
the
I don't go. My dear, it's good you have asked me that question. First of all, when they selected the team, they said technical people. I don't select the players. So they selected 20 names and they sent it to me. They said, well, go ahead, let's look for the money and they begin the training. So when they started, then time came when I said, can you give me the 15 names? Because it's me to coordinate with the responsible people. The 15 names came. After 15 names came, I needed 12 names because days are going. And that's exactly what happened. I have everything given by the people there. I did not choose any player, I want to tell you.
It is alleged that you're part of the team selection.
I wish that person could show if I was there when they selected the team. I have documents. I will show you to show that I did. I
but documents don't
papers.
Show anything that you were part of the selection. Of course, team selection is about telling Faith, I need Jarvis on the team, I need Okui on the team, so it's not about documentation.
I receive what I'm given and I forward.
Madam President, excuse me for taking you back to the first initial visit to England.
Okay, England.
The one of November, not the World Cup. I believe when you went for the World Cup, certain players did not come back, or a player did not come back. That was Halima
Nakachwa.
But I remember the one of the things that were coming up in that situation, I remember hearing someone saying that she fought with you.
Oh, Halima?
Yeah. You not like physical fight,
like
but
you
had an exchange with her, and the belief is that she decided to stay back because she thought she'd never get the opportunity to travel with the national team again. It was a rumor, that's why I'm just asking. I need a clarification.
It's good you have said, if anything, Halima is my sweetheart. She calls me Acholi Muding. That's how we call ourselves. Get her there now. And you see her, she will smile and laugh with me. Acholi Mukene, Acholi Muding. There are two that called me like that, Halima and Nanyonga, Florence. So I have nothing like that. I'm sure if you brought even Halima here now, she will tell you that is my sweetheart. She has never exchanged words to me.
Where is
Why
Liliana?
Should I?
Where is Liliana Gio?
She has injury.
She has injury.
And even when we went to England,
it was
not having.
Even
it
when
is,
was in England,
we had to take her for training, extra thing.
But it is alleged that she's not getting treatment from the Federation, yet she was on national duty.
I
she
took her to a very expensive hotel when we were in England and told her, I told doctor, let the medical people from here tell Halima,
Lillian,
what to do. When they came back, Aji is supposed to rest totally. Medically, that's what they say, to have just rest, not to jump. But of course,
because
when you come here,
yeah.
She's supposed
so
to
she
rest.
For her, she decided
she
to
was
go
given
back
to treatment.
To play?
No, all these players go back to their clubs
the
when they come back.
Is, after the doctor had the team doctor.
I'm not sure, I don't know.
Did she go back to play?
I've not followed, but I'm told she's on court.
What is it lacking at the Federation of Netball? Is it finance? Because I remember when you guys were going to England, the story that was running out that there was no enough funding in the Federation. Secondly, you had to run up and down to get money to take the girls. What do you think is lacking and what can bring money in the Federation? Like the other federations are getting money currently, they're getting money out of sports.
One thing, we don't have a sponsor. That could be our weakness, that we have not looked for a sponsor. But two, the people who sponsor us, we are sponsored by government. You people, you know very well how government lines work.
Yes.
That's why I had no complaint. They tell me, look for this, I look for it. Because I know one time it will come. So the problem is how government runs their thing, they follow the order. So, but I told people there was no problem because we were able to go. I was able to do what? Because the money came, yes, though late, but it came.
So, Madam President, you've been in charge for 5 years now?
More than that.
Close.
But the real one, I can say that I have done some work, is coming to 5 to 6 years.
Okay, so you've been in charge for about 6 years.
Why I'm saying because, as they said, from nowhere
to somewhere.
When I joined netball to now somewhere. When I joined netball, there was nothing like Uganda was not independent. We were an association member through Tanzania. So we didn't have a link. So I struggled, number one, to make sure we pay until we came independent.
Okay.
So when we affiliated ourselves to East Africa, Africa, then I made sure we reached the world to get communications. Then we started the games trials. Then we started participating. I want to tell you what gave us the exposure is when we, by the way, State House gave me money to take the team to Singapore. And that's when where the world got to know that, hey, there's
it's
a
Uganda.
Team called Uganda, and where this Uganda? These girls, I would say, they struggled and they got it. And that's when we got onto the ranking. I'm telling you, from no ranking, the first number we got in ranking was 18, 16, 15, 13, 12. When we qualified to go to Commonwealth Games, we were ranked number 12. By the time we were going to play the real game, we were number 9. We finished, came back, somewhere we went to 8. Then just before we were in 7, then from 8 to 7, just before when we qualified this time to go to this last World Cup, we were ranked number 7. Just a week to the game, we came down to 6. So that's what Uganda is, and that's where we are.
And
determination takes it all, and I'm very happy that somewhere we are going. Another group that gave us assist and exposure is Parliament of Uganda.
When a friend of mine heard that you're coming on the show, she said that she heard that you're contesting for on Africa Netball Council. Is it true?
That she heard. I'm not contesting. My name is already there.
Yeah? Give me 5.
I like
wow.
that.
Wow.
Mommy.
Your name is already there.
We are going to have a meeting
with your PRO
on the 17th.
Yeah, you have to consult.
No.
You, Susan, Susan, you have to consult your PRO. So
yes,
she will tell us.
Faith, can you the meeting will be in South Africa.
It will be in Cape Town on the 17th. No,
before
the tournament. Yeah, we are supposed to go. I hope I will be able to get a visa.
Faith, you had a question
anyway,
for her before we go for
break. It's okay. We shall have our Congress on the 17th, the whole day, then at the end of it, we go for officially the election.
Okay. Yes. Anyway, for me, my
they are very submitted. And by the way, I have submitted for vice president.
Woo!
Development.
Anyway, my question.
So
was,
shall wait.
Oh, my okay. question Fine. Was after all those years.
By the way, before you do that, I am supported by my immediate boss. They have written a letter.
Who is the immediate boss?
Secretary of National Council. Of
so make sure, no, make sure when you're submitting in whatever, you know that PRO is already here.
You're national TV.
No, I've submitted the verdict. We shall go for the election and see what it's like.
Okay.
It's better and hope that I will be somewhere.
Anyway, I was asking, in the 6 years you've been in the leadership position in the Netball Federation, how would you rate the work you've done? And do you have any regrets about all the things that have cropped up? Because, you know, people have had issues with you. An investigation was done by another media house on you, and the report was damning, if anything. So do you have any regrets? And how
do you remember what I said in the beginning when I was talking about Olima?
Mm.
Problem makes you stronger.
Mm.
When people discuss you, you go through trials and what, you become a very strong person. I am what I am today because of what I have gone through all.
Mm.
And this talking gives me more confidence
wow.
to move on.
I know, superwoman.
They're talking, yeah.
So is the team ready for African Netball Championship?
Yeah, the team is set.
Mm.
And we are in good B.
Okay.
With the two other East African countries.
Kenya, Tanzania.
Then the other ones, with two other South
Who
African
do you think
countries.
Are your most rival in East Africa, among the East African countries?
East
and
Africa.
The one you fear most?
Uganda is still on top. I want to tell
anyway.
You why I'm saying that. Tanzania, that voters online, dropped. No, they didn't have any banking anywhere.
Yeah.
Because of this sudden change, greed of what, it dropped. Now we have just, because I got tired of being alone as Uganda on the team, we supported. And Tanzania is now coming up. They are going to play. This is their first game
okay.
because they are not ranked. Even Kenya, they totally dropped. They are now coming. We are trying to get them so that they get onto their ranking. So that as East Africa, I also have some strength.
Before we go for a break, you haven't told us of your achievements. What have you achieved?
Oh, achievement. From nowhere, you are ranked. Oh, that's an achievement.
Hey, one.
Mm-hmm. Vice President, Africa Netball Council.
Becoming yeah.
Independent.
Getting that independent.
Uh-huh.
Getting an office when I came. Do you want listen? When I came, do you know the office was in the pocket? Everything was in the pocket. Was everything? But today, you can Netball as an office. You have never gone to Lugogo and see. You see the figure. And it is said,
and
we have a computer,
stand.
We
who's
have a website, we have
money. Who's the pocket? Who was
don't
the
worry, where we took from.
Should we expect the girls to be given, you know, more facilitation 2 years to come?
I'm not sure. You see, somebody upstairs let them get. But middlemen, maybe you think it is not good for the ladies.
I'm very positive.
Let me tell you, when you have little money, you perform better. This more money is here, spoiling people, the mind of people. You begin talking about the monies
which
and
ones?
The what.
Which ones? For which
Whichever.
Federation?
So you would rather these girls don't get more?
No, they should get. They should get.
Mm.
But I mean, at the time when we are playing, other people come in. You know, it's not really the girls. But has outside there.
Anyway, thank you, Suzanne. That has been Suzanne Alek for you. She's been highlighting most of the, you know, unanswered questions. Let's go for a short commercial break. We'll be right back.
Sportswoman is brought to you.